Oh, hi Mark. Did you know you can make a 3D reconstruction using a video from your cell phone? You don't need a fancy iPhone with a LiDAR scanner for that. Well, there are certain limitations, but also the iPhone has limitations. The limitations are going to come from the video quality itself. There are some issues in the videos from phones, like the motion blur, or the noise, or the denoise. If you're trying to get rid of the motion blur using high frame rate, you're going to have noise. And if you don't have noise, that's because your phone is cleaning the noise from the video itself at the same time that it's recording the video. So, I'm forgetting something. Oh, yes, the video stabilization. Digital video stabilization is going to give you glitches or video deformations, but anyway, you can use them. It doesn't mean it's not going to work at all. It's going to work with quality limitations. If you are on a vacation or you need some fast scouting of a place, or just you see something and you say, "Oh my God, I feel inspiration with this. I want a 3D reference for the future so I can make it a sculpture or whatever." Well, you can go and shoot a video around your object. You move a little bit up and down, or if you're in a place, you can walk just like this, and it's going to be more friendly for your environment because, if you're on a vacation and if you work with photogrammetry and you are just like we do in photogrammetry, stay still, picture, move a little bit, stay still, picture, move a little bit, don't breathe, don't you ever breathe, take a picture, and everyone around is going to look you very funny. In our experience, I have this crappy video here. This is 720p video with motion blur, video stabilization, glitches and deformations, and it has some noise cleaning. In fact, it looks pretty much like washed out. There is no definition that I can take for the textures. But anyway, I'm going to take this video and I'm going to make a 3D model from it. So let's go with it step by step. The first place I'm using here, MetaShape. I go to File, Import, Import Video, and I will bring my crappy video here. So what is MetaShape doing with my video? Well, MetaShape is going to make a keyframe extraction, like one keyframe, or 15 or 20 frames, then it will extract another keyframe and let 10 frames and so on. So the first thing here is to choose an output folder for your individual images. Well, I'm going to put folder here called tutorial and frame step. That is important. This video is around half minute, so I need a large frame step. I don't want 300 keyframes with a very low quality to process. That's a lot. So in frame step, choose large, and this is going to give me around 65 or 70 images for processing the camera positions. So go there, click in OK, and wait for a few minutes. Now that the video is processed, you will find a chunk here with the 70 cameras. You can check your cameras right here. Right? Now, the next step is go to your workflow menu and align photos. Now, I'm going to use accuracy highest and reference preselection estimated. Click OK and wait for another few minutes. Finally, the sparse point cloud appears. Here you can see 70 over 70 aligned. That's pretty good. Let's check the camera's position. Nice. Well, you can see something from what you're going to try to, you know, 3D-fy here. And my next step is going to be arrange the area of capturing or reconstruction. I'm going to rotate a little bit this volume and just make it not so wide. And there we go. Now, I will go to Workflow, Dense Cloud, just for a preview of what I'm capturing. And in quality, I will let this in medium and let MetaShape work. Now I can hit here on my Dense Cloud, and this is not bad at all. We have a little bit of occlusion, of course, on this pole. Alright, the side of the pole that was not captured in the video is not going to appear on the 3D model. And there is some occlusion here in the stroller handle. But the overall result is very good for a so low quality video. My next step is go to Workflow, Build Mesh, and I will use Depth Maps. This is going to take a minute or two. Once the reconstruction is done, I can go here to see my model. And it's a low resolution model with no details, but it's very clear. I mean, we have a nice result here for a few seconds, bad quality video. And now the last step, I go to Workflow, Build Texture, and 4K for this is, it's maybe too much, but let it be. Well, the texture has been created, so I'll drop down this list to Model Texture, and there we have. Considering the quality of the video, this is a very good result here. And that's all what you need. You need more for that. You know, it's just a half minute video with a very low resolution, a very bad quality, and anyway, it's being able to capture all these from the place. And okay, I hope this video has something useful for you. And I'll see you next time. Well, I'm not going to see you next time. Maybe you see me next time. Subscribe. And I hope you have a perfect weekend. It's not weekend? Anyway, have a perfect weekend. Bye.